أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد. Once again everyone, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So today inshallah some things about Surah Al-Kawthar, the shortest surah in the Quran, to be able to understand its placement and its logic. There are a couple of things. First, to understand the background of this surah, which takes a little bit of time to understand. It surrounds one of the saddest incidents in the Prophet's life, alayhi salatu wasalam, when his young baby boy passed away. And when this baby boy passed away, that's painful enough, but it was actually even more painful that his next door neighbor, which was his actual uncle, heard of the news. He could hear the crying on the other side of the porch, separated by just a wall, and started kind of prancing around, declaring out loud, "Batara Muhammad, Batara Muhammad, Muhammad's name shall not continue. Muhammad's son," because sons pass on the name, "his name shall not continue." He's celebrating the death of a baby. Now it's hard enough to deal with the death of a child, impossible even. And on top of that, your own uncle is celebrating that fact. I mean, this is the kind of thing where even noble enemies will drop their sword and say, "Look, we're enemies, but today I heard your child passed away. We'll take a day break, and give a consolation, and condolences." But this is your own uncle, and he's celebrating the pain on top of the pain that the Prophet ﷺ felt. So Allah kind of changed his mood completely, and that's one of the powers of the Quran. Like, Allah's word will make you see the same reality completely differently. And without Allah's word, you'll see it one way, and with it, you'll see it some other way. So instead of focusing on what the Prophet ﷺ has lost, what does Allah do? "Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar." We've given you the greatest, the most abundant good. The most abundant good, of course, is described as a river in paradise, but the generality of the language also suggests, I've given you so much good. The word kathir means a lot, but al-kawthar is mubalagha. It's good beyond imagination. That's what we've given you. And I've given you much and much and much. So instead of thinking about the loss, which is unbearable to think about, Allah focuses the Prophet's attention on what he's been given. And that's actually a universal lesson that we're learning in this incredible surah. Another quick thing about it is Allah tells His Messenger, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Pray for your master, pray for the sake of your master, and sacrifice. Sacrifice is done usually for a aqiqah, for a celebration. And Allah is saying, what I've given you, you should still celebrate. And don't worry, you're the enemy, the one who's caused you pain, إِنَّ شَانِيَكَ, he's the one that's going to be the most discontinued. هُوَ الْأَبْتَرْ. He's the most discontinued. His name and his legacy shall not continue. Now, this is the historical background of this surah, but the placement of the surah is also remarkable. It's Suratul Fil, fulfilling half the prayer of Ibrahim, keep the city peaceful. Surat Quraysh, fulfilling the other half of the prayer of Ibrahim, make the city prosperous. Suratul Ma'un, showing that the people who are currently in charge are not capable. They're not rightly qualified to run the house of Allah. They're not qualified as custodians of the Kaaba. And then Suratul Kawthar, you are the rightful custodian. You're the one that's been given abundant good. And as a matter of fact, what he's told to do, pray and sacrifice, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ, is actually, in summary, the entire legacy of Abraham. On the one hand, رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ, make me the establisher of prayer. That's Ibrahim's prayer, alayhi salam. And on the other hand, of course, the entire ritual of sacrifice traces back to Ibrahim, alayhi salam. So in two words, the Prophet is being told, restore the legacy of your father. It's incredible, so beautiful. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. And then the Prophet's being told, by the way, those who have already been described as not qualified to run this house will become your enemy, but don't worry, their legacy shall not continue. That house will be worshipped. The worship will take place at that house in the way, and continue to take place in that house in the way that is true to the spirit of Ibrahim, alayhi salam. And that is something we continue to enjoy to this day. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.